Hello, I'm Marta, and this is 21st episode about rebuild of my DR350S. In this episode, we will begin the rear brake assembly, starting with the rear brake caliper and its bracket. First, let's unpack the rear brake repair kit. Here you can see the old dust seal and the new one. It's good to compare the old parts with the new ones to be sure we've got the right parts. During assembling, we will use brake fluid to lube all the parts, so I pour a little bit of it to a separate container. I'm using DOT4 brake fluid according to the service manual. We start with the piston seal. We lube it with the brake fluid and install it gently in the inner groove of caliper. In the end, make sure that the seal fits in the groove properly. We repeat the same for the dust seal, we just put it in the inner upper groove. A little optical inspection. Next, we use special grease to lube the dust seal. I also lube the piston with thin layer of grease. Now we can insert the piston. You must align it to the cylinder hole so it will not block during sliding in. Next, we will put back the shaft bolt rubber boot, so we lube it with the brake fluid and insert it to the caliper. There is also some kind of plaque on the top of the caliper. We don't know why it is there, but maybe you have some ideas. Afterwards, we screw in the brake bleeder screw using torque between 6 to 9 Newton meters. In the end, we can put on the cap. Next, we screw in the shaft bolt. Before this, we use a thread locking fluid. We torque the shaft bolt with 20 to 25 Newton meters. After that, we insert the spring pad. Now we can put back the brake pads. I use the old ones because they are still thick. I just brush them with a metal brush. Next, we secure the brake pad using the mounting pin. To slide it in, you need to press in the brake pads. In the end, we tighten the pins with 15 to 20 Newton meters torque. Now for a moment we will switch to the bracket. So now we mount the rubber boot and the retainer clip. We use the thread locking fluid on the shaft bolt and screw it into the bracket. Next, I use some grease to lube the rubber boot and the hole where the shaft bolt is sliding. We do the same with the rubber shaft boot, which is mounted in the caliper. After that, we've got to get rid of the grease excess, which gets out of the boots. Finally, we can join the brake caliper with the bracket. The brake caliper should slide freely on the bracket. Now it's time to install new stainless steel brake hose. First, we mount a banjo fitting with a banjo bolt and two new crash washers. We torque the banjo bolt with torque between 20 to 25 Newton meters. Next, we connect hose to the banjo fitting. We use the thread locking fluid on the thread end. After tightening the connector by hand, we need to torque it with 10 Newton meters. To do this, we need a special torque wrench or some MAF. As we know, torque is some force applied on a lever. As a lever, we will use a flat branch of 0.125 meters length. To generate 100 newtons of force, we will use a 10 kilograms weight plate. So in the end, if we multiply the lever length by the force, we will get 12.5 newton meters torque, so it should be okay. As you see, it works. Now we can use our awesome engineering device to tighten the connector with the proper torque. The last step is putting back the caliper cover guard by screwing two bolts. The brake caliper is ready, but we still need a master cylinder and some brake fluid, so we will take care of them in the next episode. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed, leave a like and stay tuned for the next videos documenting DR rebuilding.